إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله خير النبي اشتباه وهدى للعالمين أرسله الله بدين الحق لينذر عدين كل ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأزواجه وذريته وأصحابه وتابعين وتابعين بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد عباد الله أذكركم وإياي بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى وذكركم من قوله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم حيث يقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وذكركم بسنة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وحفظ القرآن الكريم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. It's as if we are hosting a unique, most honored, most generous guest. A guest we are blessed to host once a year for the duration of a month. The guest arrives at an appointed time and departs at an appointed time. The beauty of this guest is that it brings the most sought after gifts for the one desiring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It brings Allah's mercy and generosity and disperses it to those who avail themselves. It brings us ease that draws near to our Lord, His pleasure, and His garden. It distances us from the hellfire and protects us from Shaitan and his whispers. It brings with it the fragrance of the garden. It brings life to the hearts and eternal speech of the ever-living Creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It fills our homes with family and friends and loved ones. This guest is the month of Ramadan. The month of Qur'an, the month of Laylatul Qadr, the month of Rahmah, the month of forgiveness, the month of liberation from the hellfire, the month of patience, the month of reflection and renewed spiritual commitment, the month of charity for the under-resourced and solidarity with the underserved. It is this month when deeds are multiplied, the month of the pre-dawn suhoor meal and the meal at the end of the day of iftar. It is a month when deeds are multiplied, the month of Qiyam and the restful evening prayer. We're reminded our tradition that the one who believes in Allah in his last day, then let him honor his guest. Insha'Allah, Allah will give us the ability in upholding the obligations in honoring this guest, Allahumma Ameen. It is from the mercy of Allah that we are allowed to honor, that we are allowed to host this guest, while others who have residence in proximity to this place do not have that honor of hosting this guest. As a reminder from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who said, on the authority of Salman Farsi, who related that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that this blessed month has come upon you, a month containing Laylatul Qadr, which is better than 1,000 months. Allah has made fasting obligatory during it, and steadfastly observing its nights in worship as a voluntary act. Whoever undertakes an act of obedience during the month with a righteous deed, it is as if he has performed an obligatory act in other times, and whoever performs an obligatory act during it is as one who has performed 70 obligations in other times. It is a month of patience, and the reward for patience is paradise. May Allah make us of those people. It is a month of goodwill during which provisions are multiplied. The Prophet ﷺ continues in this hadith by saying, whoever feeds a fasting person will be compensated with forgiveness of sins and salvation of his soul from hell. He will also receive a reward equal to the person of that person that he feeds without causing them any reductions. The Prophet ﷺ said, or the companion said to the Messenger of Allah ﷺ, not all of us have the ability to feed a person. The Prophet ﷺ said, that Allah gives a reward whoever feeds a person with even just a taste of milk or dates or a drink of water. Whoever quenches the thirst of a fasting person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make them drink from my pond, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That which you will never feel thirsty again until he enters the paradise. It is a month whose beginning is mercy, whose middle is forgiveness, and whose end is emancipation from the hellfire. May Allah allow us to be hosts that will give honor to this guest. I wanted to use that as setting a precedent for, alhamdulillah, what we are experiencing now in almost 48 hours as we approach our second day of Ramadan. However, my message is this. My message is to all of us who have transgressed against our souls. We all came into the month with high hopes this Ramadan. And we want this Ramadan to be different. We want to get out of the rut of the shortcomings that we find within ourselves. And all of us have set goals for this month. But only 2 days have gone by. And perhaps we find ourselves still attached to those bad habits. And our first response may be to become angry with ourselves. We promised ourselves that we would make all of our prayers on time. We promised that we would be patient with people. We pledged to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we would leave off those things in our lives that we know are major wrongs. But yet they stare at us every day in the face. We are struggling with our prayers perhaps. Shouting at a loved one. A mother, a spouse, or a child. But then we ask, maybe Ramadan is not for people like myself. Because I always mess up. Every single time. The fact that the devils, the shayateen, are locked up during this month, I think maybe has no impact on me. I'm referring to the hadith here that puts Ramadan squarely, the reality and the obligations of Ramadan, squarely with myself. The hadith that the doors of mercy of paradise are flung open and the gates of hell are locked. So Allah pours out His mercy onto this earth and holds back the evil that comes out of the hellfire. Those baseless misgivings, the whispers, the shayateen being locked up. That means that the reality of Ramadan, the reality of those blameworthy things that I see inside myself, the negative aspects that I see inside myself, is not shaytan, that is me. That is me. Alhamdulillah, this month gives me a blessed opportunity of 29 or 30 days to come to know myself at a deeper level. So alhamdulillah, just as we go to the physician and they give us an analysis of our health, this is now the ability to find out where we stand in relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person may ask themselves, contemplating, giving into those misgivings of shaytan, maybe I'm a lost cause. Maybe there's no hope for me. Maybe I don't deserve the blessings and the mercy of Ramadan. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is rejecting me. Perhaps all of these doubts enter into our minds. If this describes any of the feelings that you are having, then you have misunderstood the reality. The reality is that Ramadan was made for people such as this. It was made for this person with shortcomings and sin that stands in front of you right now. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, and this is the month of Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, and this is the month of the Quran, say, O my servants who have transgressed against themselves, do not despair of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not despair of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give glad tidings to each other for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give glad tidings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us life to be in this month. Give glad tidings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put us in this community that is filled with love and rahmah and mercy and generosity. Allahumma ameen. Allah forgives all sins, the verse continues. Indeed, it is He who is the forgiving, the merciful. Sometimes we are harsher on ourselves than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be. We punish ourselves by telling ourselves that we do not deserve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that makes us give up on both ourselves and on God and on His mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But know this, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy is not deserved. Rather, it is given to all, especially those of us who are struggling, who are trying in spite of everything, in spite of all of the challenges that we have in our lives, in spite of the situations that have happened to us in the past, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy is there for every single one of us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ, that my mercy encompasses all things. And that mercy, as I said before, as the Prophet ﷺ has reminded us, that mercy has a special place during this month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to avail ourselves to His mercy in this month, not like we do at other times, but in a special place during these special days, in these special nights. Allahumma ameen. The Prophet ﷺ is reported to have said in a hadith that some have categorized as weak, but in our tradition with Fadal Amal, it is appropriate and it is legally sound to narrate a hadith if it is weak for the benefit of people. The Prophet ﷺ said, أَوَّلَهُ رَحْمَةُ وَسَطْعُ مَغْفِرَةُ وَأَخِيرُهُ الْإِطْفُ مِنَ النَّارِ, that the first half, the first 10 days of Ramadan are mercy. Mercy pouring down in a manner that it does not pour down in the other days of this year, making it unique. May Allah allow us to avail ourselves to those mercies. The Prophet ﷺ has said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the status that He gives us, whoever observes fasting during the month of Ramadan out of sincere faith and hoping to attain Allah's reward, then all his past sins will be forgiven. All of his past sins will be forgiven. This should reach us at our core. This should reach us and pierce all of the doubts that we have and make it into our hearts that is the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are dealing with. That is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for us to be a part of here. And may Allah give us life to see the end of this month. May Allah give us the ability to see Laylatul Qadr in this month. Ameen. Alhamdulillah, these are the gifts from our generous Lord. So we need to let things go. Qad fat mat. That which has passed is gone. What we have is right now. Let go of the anger that we feel towards ourselves, the self-doubt, a criticism that is not beneficial. Let go of these feelings of unworthiness, that somehow I am not worthy, because it's a trick of the lower self. It's a trick of the nafs. The more we antagonize ourselves, the less that we will do. The more we have hatred towards ourselves, the more we will give in to our base desires that pull us away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a vicious cycle. The iman that Allah has given us allows all of those doors to be locked. It is only these doubts that creep in that will cause the door to be opened. When we talk about this idea or this concept of some of the conversations that I have with some of the youth, if they express this idea of not being worthy, it means that they don't know their relationship vis-a-vis Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Perhaps those doubts of thoughts that they may have about themselves, about being unworthy, or if all any of us have thought about this, it's not coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ كَرَمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that I have honored the children of Adam. We are in an honored and blessed state. We are in an honored and blessed state. And on the guidance of Ali ibn Talib radiallahu anhu, may Allah be pleased with him, we don't have to wait until the end of Ramadan for an Eid, because he said, "Kulli yawm yawm Eid liman ata'a Allah." He said that every day is a day of Eid for the one who is obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every day is a day of celebration. Every day knowing that our rewards are accruing in a manner in which we can't even comprehend subhanahu wa ta'ala pouring out His generosity in this time. Allahumma ameen. So alhamdulillah, how can we move away from perhaps these doubts or these thoughts, or these bad habits that we have brought into our lives. Well, one of them is having complete trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the things that I have found in the work that I've been doing over the years is that a person has complete affirmation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the forgiver. And they have complete affirmation in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they will affirm all of the verses, and they will affirm all of the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ speaking about the divine mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the challenge is that they cannot forgive themselves. But look what the Prophet ﷺ reminds us of. He said, a person commits sin. A person committed a sin and said, my Lord, I have sinned. Forgive me. His Lord said, is my slave acknowledging that he has a Lord who forgives sins and punishes for them? I have forgiven my slave. Then as much time passed as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed, then he committed a sin and said, my Lord, I have sinned. Forgive me. His Lord said, is my slave acknowledging that he has a Lord who forgives sins and punishes for them? I have forgiven my slave. Then as much time passed as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed, then he committed a sin and said, my Lord, I have sinned, forgive me. His Lord said, is my slave acknowledging that he has a Lord who forgives sins and punishes for them? I have forgiven my slave. Allah says, I have forgiven my slave. And we know this. That if we are free from associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all of that. It will be difficult to have the type of month that we all want spiritually if we cannot allow ourselves to fall into the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be enveloped by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be permeated by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all levels of our being. We will not allow the ability of complete trust of tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore it will prevent us from having the types of openings and relationships that we can have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because that doubt is there. This concept of mercy is there to erase that doubt. Not from me, but from the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from the words of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And from the examples of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah continue to bless us. The Quran tells us what Allah ta'ala wants from us. وَاللَّهِ يُرِيدَ أَنْ يَتُوبُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَيُرِيدَ الَّذِينَ يَتَبِعُونَ شَهَوَاتِ أَنْ تَمِيلُوا مَيْلًا عَظِيمًا يُرِيدَ اللَّهُ أَنْ يُخَفِّفَ عَنْكُمْ وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. So there's two things here. Allah wants to accept your repentance. This is the relationship that we have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ready to accept with just a simple ask. But then the onus is on us to affirm that it has been accepted. But those who follow their passions want to digress into deviation, and Allah wants to lighten your difficulties. But yet man is created weak. May Allah allow us to overcome that weakness. Allahumma ameen. Alhamdulillah, this concept of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about mercy in the Quran, and He's telling us that our renewal is in our hands. He has already told us that He will forgive us if we turn back. But we need to take that step and turn back to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep trying to stop these bad habits and persist in doing good deeds. That renewal is available to us at every moment and every day. It should be at the center of our consciousness during this month. The Prophet ﷺ has said that Allah ta'ala will continue to stretch out His hand in the night so that the sinners of the day may repent. And continue to stretch out His hand in the daytime so that the sinners of the night may repent until the sun rises from the west. This past does not matter as long as we are making the choice in the present to turn back. No matter how many times we fall, returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over and over again, it is all counted in our favor. It is all counted in our favor. But one might say that I am so tired of myself. And this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's response to you if you feel that fatigue. O son of Adam, as long as you call on me, I shall forgive you of what you have done. وَلَا أُبَالِي, and think nothing of it. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا أُبَالِي. O son of Adam, even if your sins were to reach up to the clouds in the sky, and then you were to ask my forgiveness, I would forgive you. وَلَا أُبَالِي, and I would think nothing of it. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. O son of Adam, even if you were to come to me with sins nearly as great as the earth, and you were to meet me after death, not worshipping anything besides me, I would bring you forgiveness nearly as great as the earth. This hadith is narrated by Tirmidhi. Ramadan is for us, and tomorrow is a new day. This life is a struggle, and no one gets to the top of that mountain without struggle and sacrifice, without doubting and telling themselves to turn back, without thinking that they will not make it. But with the strength of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has facilitated for us a path of ease that we may make it to that top. أَقُولْنَا قَوْلِ حَذَا وَصَفِرِ لِكُمْ إِسَانَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَقْوَمِ صَفِرُ اللَّهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله عباد الله أذكركم بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى وذكركم بقول سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم حيث يقول في الحديث اتقوا الله حيثما كنتم وذكركم بشرف مكان مصطفى صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم حيث يقول الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آله سيدنا إبراهيم إنك أنت حميد Alhamdulillah, in closing here, this idea that we are ascending in the struggle of the mountain, that we don't realize that the reward is in the struggle, and when we get there, we say, Subhanallah, look what it is there. And it's always worth it. Because the up there that I'm talking about in this metaphor is not the top of the mountain, but it's something better. It's what the Prophet ﷺ could not describe. When Allah says in the hadith, when talking about Jannah, that it's what no eye has ever seen, no ear has ever heard, and what no heart has ever perceived. It's paradise. And then, alhamdulillah, that Allah says with regard to this, that our fasting, that every action, every deed of the son of Adam is for him except for fasting, and I shall reward him for that. We don't know what the reward of this deed is. But think about this in relationship to what Ali radiallahu anhu said, that if we knew what the reward would be, then what type of celebration would be every day that Allah gave us the ability to fast? Allah is saying that I have created in my paradise which no eye has ever seen, no ear has ever heard, no heart has ever perceived. And Allah says that I will take the reward of the fasting and I will keep it for myself to reward in a way that I do not reward in other things. And then Ali radiallahu anhu seals all that by saying, every day is a day of Eid for the one who is in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah allow us to celebrate. May Allah place us in the highest levels of paradise through His mercy. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all of us there. Allahumma hamil mu'mineen wal mu'minat. المسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم كن معنا ولا تكن علينا أبدا يا رب العالمين. اللهم بارك لنا في باقي أيام والأيام شهر رمضان يا رب العالمين. وبلغنا لا يتقضي يا كريم. اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا. اللهم تقبل منا صلاتنا. وتقبل منا قيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا يا رب العالمين. وتلاوة كتابك آناء أطراف النهار يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل منا جميعا يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل منا. اللهم كن معنا ولا تكون علينا أبدا يا رب العالمين. اللهم ورنا لدينك ردا جميلا يا رب العالمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقيم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.